On May 11th, 1937, Benny Goodman ventured uptown to challenge Webb in what was billed as the music battle of the century. "Fellas, this is my hour," Webb told his men. "Anybody misses notes, don't come back to work." Four 4,000 fans jammed into the ballroom, and mounted policemen and firemen had to be called to control the crowd of 5,000 more who couldn't get in and refused to go home. Among those who did get in were Norma Miller and Frankie Manning, professional Lindy Hoppers now, who had been taking on all comers in dance contests around the world. They had come home to the Savoy to see their hero face his most celebrated challenger.
The night that Benny Goodman came to play against Chick Webb, this was an electrical night. This was, yes. I mean, the
Harlem was
air of being around the Savoy Ballroom. Here's Benny Goodman, the King of Swing, and here's Chick Webb.
The King of Swing.
The King of Swing. You know, as far as we're concerned, you know, this Chick Webb going up against Benny Goodman. You know, Goodman was a giant because they called him the King of Swing at that time. And any band that played swing, we would buy that record. So we knew about Benny Goodman. A lot of people may not realize that a lot of the arrangements that Benny Goodman had, Chick Webb had the same arrangement. And when they get on a bandstand, now this is when you can know which band is the best, by listening to them play the same arrangement. Swung Benny Goodman.
I say the same thing. Yeah.
I'm not saying this because it's Chick Webb, or because I'm being prejudiced. But to me, I feel that Chick Webb outswung Benny Goodman that night.
Right.
You know, because I saw guys on Benny Goodman's bandstand when Chick Webb was playing. I seen guys on that. They sat up there and said, they just shook their heads.
The Goodman Band was routed. Gene Krupa bowed down in tribute to the man who had beaten him. Chick Webb, he said, had cut me to ribbons. Nobody, one of Webb's men remembered, could have taken it away from Chick that night.